Hey class, welcome back. Today we're still talking about World War II. We've got two or three lessons left for it. We've got the Holocaust today, and we've got D-Day, and then we've got Hiroshima and Nagasaki for our lessons. And but today we're talking about the Holocaust, and it was one of the most terrible times in human history. Adolf Hitler, he decided he didn't like Jews. He didn't like people that was outside of his race, the Aryan race or German race, and decided, you know, I'm just going to get do away with them. And he wound up killing about 6 million Jewish people during World War II and about 17 million people that were different from him throughout the war. And that's what we're talking about, the Holocaust. It was a dark, dark time in human history. So what was the Holocaust? It is one of the most terrible events in human history, like I said, and it occurred during World War II when Hitler was leader of Germany. 6 million Jewish people were murdered by the Nazis during this time. Included as many as 1 million Jewish children. All right, he didn't discriminate about that, about who he killed. If you were outside of German, Aryan, he killed you. It didn't matter. All right. Millions of other people that Hitler didn't like were killed. All right. Polish people, Catholics, Serbs. He also disabled people, okay, or handicapped people, okay, and it's thought that he murdered as many as 17 million people during this time.
What was it? The Holocaust is one of the most terrible events in human history. It occurred during World War II when Hitler was leader of Germany. 6 million Jewish people were murdered by the Nazis. This included as many as 1 million Jewish children. Millions of other people that Hitler didn't like were killed as well. This included Polish people, Catholics, Serbs, and handicapped people. It's thought that the Nazis murdered as many as 17 million innocent people.
So why did Hitler and the Nazis do this? All right. Well, Hitler, he hated Jewish people. He blamed them for losing World War I. All right, and he considered them to be less than human. All right, that's just how he believed. And he believed in his race, the Aryan race, being superior. And he wanted to use Darwinism and breeding to create a superior race of perfect people, or what he believed to be perfect people. So this is why he did this.
Why did Hitler and the Nazis do it? Hitler hated Jewish people and blamed them for Germany losing World War I. He considered Jewish people to be less than human. Hitler also believed in the superiority of the Aryan race. He wanted to use Darwinism and breeding to create a race of perfect people, or what he believed was perfect.
All right. So he wrote in his book, Mein Kampf, that when he became ruler, he would rid Germany of all Jews. And not many people believed he'd really do this. But as soon as he became the chancellor, he started his work against the Jews. He made laws that Jews had no rights. He organized attacks on Jewish businesses and homes. November 9, 1938, many Jewish homes and businesses were burnt down or vandalized, and it was called the Night of Broken Glass. So he really, really detested Jewish people and blamed them for what happened in World War I.
Why did Hitler and the Nazis do it? Continue. Hitler wrote in his book, Mein Kampf, that when he became ruler, he would rid Germany of all Jews. Not many people believed he would really do this, but as soon as he became chancellor, he started this work against the Jews. He made laws that said Jews had no rights. Then he organized attacks on Jewish businesses and homes. On November 1938, many Jewish homes and businesses were vandalized. This night was called Kristallnacht, or Night of Broken Glass.
All right, so during World War II, when the Nazis would take over a city in Europe, all right, they would take all the Jewish people and they'd put them in one area of the town. And this area was called a ghetto. It was fenced in with barbed wire. It was guarded. There was little to no food, little water, no medicine available. And it was crowded with multiple families living they're sharing a single room to live in. So it's what they did. They put them in what was called a ghetto.
Ghettos. Jews. During World War II, when the Nazis would take over a city in Europe, they would force all the Jewish people into an area of one area of the town. This area was called a ghetto and was fenced in with barbed wire and guarded. There was little food, water, or medicine available. It was also very crowded, with multiple families sometimes sharing a single room to live in.
All right. And it also, all these Jewish people were eventually, they'd move them from the ghetto to what was called a concentration camp. All right. And they were told, hey, we're relocating you to a new and better place. But it was not like that. All right. They were taking them to these concentration camps. These concentration camps were like prison camps. They were forced to do hard labor while they were there. The weak were quickly killed or they died of starvation. Some camps even had what was called gas chambers. All right. And they would lead all these people into large groups into the gas chamber all at one time. And they would pump poisonous gas into it and kill them all. All right. They were horrible, horrible places. And like I said, I can't stress enough how bad it was, and dark this time was in human history.
Concentration camps. All Jewish people were eventually to be brought to a concentration camp. They were told they were relocating to a new and better place, but this was not the case. Concentration camps were like prison camps. People were forced to do hard labor. The weak were quickly killed or died of starvation. Some camps even had gas chambers. People would be led into the chambers in large groups only to be killed with poison gas. The concentration camps were horrible places.
All right, so a lot of these Jewish people, they knew that if they were seen, if anything happened to them, you know, if they saw them, whatever, they're going to capture them, and they were going to be forced into the ghetto or the concentration camps. So they hid during the war. Some of them pretended to be part of a family, and sometimes they would hide in hidden rooms or basement, and they would do this for a long period of time because the war went on for like 6 years. So some were able to eventually escape across the border, but a lot of them hid for years, a lot of times in the same room.
Hiding. Many Jewish people hid from the Nazis during World War II. They would hide with non-Jewish families. Sometimes they would pretend to be a part of the family, and sometimes they would hide in hidden rooms or in the basement or attic. Some were able to eventually escape across the border into a free country, but many hid for years, sometimes in the same room.
All right, and you had all kinds of stories that came out of the Holocaust, such as Anne Frank here. Many stories of the Jewish people were striving to survive. Anne Frank's diary was one of them. This diary tells the real-life story of a young girl named Anne Frank. She and her family, they hid from the Nazis for 2 years. And then they were betrayed and captured, and they sent her to a concentration camp, and she eventually died in a concentration camp, but her diary survived to tell her story.
Stories and heroes of the Holocaust. There are many stories of Jewish people striving to survive during the Holocaust and the heroes who helped them. Here are a few. Anne Frank's diary. This diary tells the real-life story of a young girl named Anne Frank. She and her family hid from the Nazis for 2 years before they were betrayed and captured. Anne died in a concentration camp, but her diary survived to tell her story.
And you had Schindler's List. All right, there's a movie, the story of Oscar Schindler, who was a German businessman, and he managed to save lives of 1,000 Jewish people who worked in his factories. And then you had The Hiding Place. All right, there's another story. Where the Dutch lady who helped hide Jewish people from the Nazis. So there's all kinds of different stories that came out of the Holocaust, you know, stories of survivors, story of people who helped people survive, Anne Frank's diary, Schindler's List, The Hiding Place, all these different things.
Stories and heroes of the Holocaust continue. Schindler's List. This movie tells the story of Oscar Schindler, a German businessman who managed to save the lives of over 1,000 Jewish people who worked in his factories. The Hiding Place. This tells the true story of Cor ten Boom, a Dutch lady who helped to hide Jewish people from the Nazis. Corey gets caught by a spy, however, and is sent to the concentration camp. Corey survives the camp and is let free at the end of the war.
All right, so how many people in total did the Nazis kill during the Holocaust? Was it A, 17 million, B, 0, or C, 10? It was 17 million people is what they thought, they believed. They know it's 6 million Jewish people for certain, and up to 17 million people.
Ding, ding, ding.
Which is crazy, y'all. It's ridiculous. All right, number two, what book did Hitler write where he said he wanted to rid Germany of the Jews? Was it A, Dr. Seuss, B, Mein Kampf, or C, nothing? It is B, Mein Kampf.
Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner.
He wrote in this book, hey, I want to get rid of all the Jewish people. Nobody took him serious at first until he became chancellor and started doing it. Number three, where did the Germans put Jewish people when they took over a city? A, in the penthouse, B, in a condo, or C, in the ghetto? It was C, in a ghetto. They crammed them in these buildings and with, you know, many people living in this one little single area with put barbed wire around it, made a lot of families live in one different room. So, and then eventually they took them to concentration camps.
Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner.
Number four, what was the name of the places where Jewish people were taken to work or get killed? A, the concentration camp, B, Camp Nowhere, or C, the woods? It is A, concentration camp, where they would take them to be killed for the most part.
Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner.
Number five, where were people in the concentration camp taken to get killed with poisonous gas? A, the gas chamber, B, the gallows, or C, nowhere? They were taken to a gas chamber. They would bring a bunch of them in there at one time, put poisonous gas in it, and just kill all of them at one time.
Ding, ding, ding.
Just crazy.
We have a winner.
Number six, what young girl wrote a journal of her life hiding for 2 years from the Nazis? A, Pippi Longstocking, B, Anne Frank, or C, JoJo Siwa? It was B, Anne Frank, who wrote she eventually died in the concentration camp, but her diary survived, and they've made a book out of it.
Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner.
All right. That is all for today. We'll be back next time. We're going to be talking about the invasion of Normandy, or D-Day, as it's called. And then the next one, and our last one for the World War II, will be Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the bombing of them. So I will see you all next time. You all have a very good day. I'll see you later.